Warm greetings. Welcome for online video session on operating system. Myself Jagdish Ayan, Associate Professor, Department of Computer Science, Canada Engineering College. In the last video session, we saw about memory management unit. So memory management. In that, we saw about the base register, logical base register, limit registers, and logical addresses, physical addresses, and about the steps in multiprocessing execution time, load time, compile time, etc. So in this video session we'll continue the next topic about swapping. A process can be swapped temporarily out of memory to backing store and then brought back into memory and continued execution. Backing store fast disk large enough to accommodate the copies of all memory images for all the users, but must provide a direct access to these memory images. So there will be a memory image that is from the secondary disk to the primary, that is main memory. All the processor has to bring back to this for the execution in the main memory. So operating system is placed above this. Process will be placed below the operating system, and this process has to come from the secondary memory as to access. Rollout in swapping variant used for priority based scheduling algorithm. Lower priority process is swapped out, so higher priority process can be loaded and executed. So there are some process which will be stored in the secondary memory. So depending upon the priority, the process has to be accessed to the main memory, and the lower priority will be sent back to the secondary memory. So first the priority will be given to the which is having higher priority, that is a processor which is having higher priority. Major part of the swap time is transfer time. Total transfer time is directly proportional to the amount of memory swapped. Modified version of swappings are found on many systems, that is like example like Windows operating system, Windows, Linux, system maintenance, ready queue of ready to run process which have memory images on the disk. So in the memory, there is main memory, each and every operating, there is each and every processors will have images. That images will be stored in the main memory. So which based upon the images, seeing the images of the processors, the priority can be decided. So that based on that priority, the processors, that is CPU, will access the process which is stored in the secondary memory for the execution purposes. So here you can see the semantic view of swapping. So operating system always have main memory above, that will be placed to operating system. This part is entirely occupied by the operating system, and remaining spaces will be given for the processors for the execution of the CPU. So in the secondary memory, there is accessing and there is rollout and roll in will be done based upon the priority, that is swap out and swap in. The process example according to this, the process P1 having a lower priority will be swapped out, and process which is having higher priority will be swapped into the main memory for the execution purposes. So contiguous allocation. Main memory usually divide into two partition. One is for the operating system and for the processors to which is held in I memory. So this is actually main memory. This part is occupied by the operating system, and remaining part is occupied for the execution of the processors. Relocation registers used to protect the user process from each other and from challenging operating system, code and data. So base registers contains the value of the smallest physical addresses. So whenever the processors are created, there will be a base register as well as limit register. Okay, so base register is the starting address of the processors, and limit register is the end of this location or end of the processors. So base register contains the value of the smallest physical addresses. Limit register contains the range of the logical addresses. Each logical addresses must be less than the limit register. So this is a limit register, and the logical registers, the logical addresses should be less than the limit register. So it cannot cross the limit register addresses. So memory management unit maps the logical addresses dynamically. So memory management unit, so in which is placed in between the CPU as well as memory, sorry, main memory. So that takes care allocate the logical addresses dynamically, which is that memory management unit. So you can see the CPU, based on the limit register, the logical address which is produced by the CPU, so it should be lesser than the limit register. So logical address should be lesser than the limit register. If it is yes, then it can continue and it can relocate the registers, that is whatever the address should be produced along with that is the addition, and will be stored back to the physical memory, that is main memory, sorry, secondary memory. If the logical address is greater than or equals to the limit register, then the trap will be occur. So whenever you come across executing the program, so some of that will be showing addressing, that is error addressing, because of that is it is an internal problem, that is registers problem you come across. So it should be always lesser than the limit register. Contiguous allocation. So multiple partition allocation. So here you can see here the memory will be, or a process will be divided into number of parts. So the process will be placed in the memory. So for example, process 1 is placed at this location, process 2 is placed at this location, and process 3 is located at this location. Wherever the number is been written, that are all the process which is occupied, and empty is a, we call it as a hole. Okay, we call it as a hole. So hole or a block of available memory, holes of various sizes are scattered throughout the memory. So while designing a operating system, so the developers, based on if he or he will design the memory location in such a way that the maximum size of the process, he may know that maximum size of the process, what is the size it going to occupy. So that number of size or block will be designed by the designer of the operating system. So that process has to be sit in that particular block. So based on that, it will be designing the memory. So when a process arrives, it is allocated a memory from a hole large enough to accommodate. When a process arrives, it is allocated a memory from a hole large enough to accommodate. When a process arrives from the CPU to the main memory, based on that, it will occupy the location which is large enough than that process size. So for example, process size is of 15k, then the hole is of 20k, it will definitely will going to occupy the size which is bigger than the actual size. So remaining 5k is waste of space. Operating system maintains information about the allocated partition and free partitions. So nothing but the hole. So there you can see a process 5, 8 and 2. So always the main memory above, it is operating system. So process 5 above the below that process 8, which is having a bigger location, because the bigger size of that process is bigger compared to any other processors. So after execution, that space remains empty. So process 9 comes, which is lesser than the actual size. So that much of process, the size will be allocated to the process 9 and get executed. And if the process, another process comes, so which is very, very lesser than that, so it will be divided, that is partition that part, and it gives that space to the process 10. So this is how the partition keeps on happening in this continuous allocation memory. So dynamic storage allocation problem. So if the process size is of same, then there is no problem. If the process size is depending upon the some process size may be of 15k, some process may be of 10k, and some processes of maybe of 25k, dynamically allocation has to be happen in the memory. So for that, we'll see how it works, how to satisfy the requested of size n from the list of three free holes. That is, first one is first fit, best fit, worst fit. So first fit, best fit and worst fit. So you can see here in this memory location, there is a upper size always will be the operating system. So process P1 is occupied, which is of 5K, okay, and process P2 is free, which is of 15K. That is, here this space is free, and process P2 is of 3K, is occupied. So, and you can see here you have around this is for the free of, which is of 25K. Okay, now processor P3 enters to the location. Here the process P3 is of, which is of 10K, which is of 10K. When it enters, it fit, it always, it will take big enough than the actual process size. So when it enters, it looks 15K, which is big enough to the process 10K. So it will go into occupy here P3. So even though there is a 10K, for example, 10K is available at this location, it won't occupy the this. So which is always bigger than the actual size of the process, it will occupy the memory location. So 15K is bigger than the actual process size, so it occupies here. There is a first fit. Best fit allocates the smallest hole that is big enough. Smallest hole that is big enough must search the entire list unless ordered by size. Produces smallest leftover hole. So best fit, for example, when you think that P4 comes which is of 15K, which is 15K, so think that this is of 17K, okay, size of 17K. So since it's a 15K, it will search entire thing, entire memory, so which is having 15K. So 25K is a much more, and it is stuck 17K. 17K is compared to 25, it is very less, but it is greater than 15K. So P4 will be occupied at this location. So this is a best fit. So here the only 2K is wasted, the memory space is wasted. So here 5K best fit. So comparative to this, which is find best while searching, that will be occupied by the process. Worst fit allocates the largest hole, must also search the entire list, produces the largest left hole. So what happens in the worst case, the entire process, the entire memory will be searched, out of which is having highest space, that will be occupied by the processes. So here compared to worst fit, best fit and first fit is better than the worst fit, because here the memory wasted in the best fit and first fit is very less compared to worst fit. So fragmentation. So here you are going to see the external fragmentation as well as internal fragmentation. So total memory space exists to satisfy a request, but it is not continuous and therefore cannot be used. So first fit analysis reveals that n allocated blocks, another 0.5n blocks will be lost to the fragmentation. 1/3 of the memory may be unuseful, 50% rule. So in internal fragmentation, allocated memory may be slightly larger than the requested memory. The size differences in memory internal to a partition but not being used, and can be for example can be happen if there is a whole size is of 15,000 bytes and processor needs 19,900 bytes, keeping a whole of size 100 bytes is not worth the effort, so the process is allocated 15,000 bytes. So actually what happened in the external fragmentation, so there will be a memory content, there is a, you can see here one example I will show here. So there is a operating system, however it is placed here. Process P1 is placed, which is of 10K, and here process P3 is placed, where this is of 15K, where it is occupies only a 10K, remaining 5K is wasted. Now another process comes, which is of this is of 10K, but it another process comes, this is empty, another process comes which is of P4, where it requires 15K, but the space is varying, having a only 10K. So what happens during the external fragmentation, the whatever the memory is been occupied here, so it will push and the remaining process memory will be pushed down. So here the entire before it was 10K, now additional 5K, so total together 15K.
So 15k space is available for the process P4. So this is how we can do the compaction is possible. So compaction is possible only if relocation is dynamic and is done at the execution time. Input output problem cannot perform compaction while input output operation is in progress involving. So memory that is being used, memory is being compacted. Latch job in memory while is involved in input output. Do the input output only into the OS.
So this is how it will happen in the external fragmentation. So non-contiguous allocation, partition the program into a number of small unit. Partition the program into number of small unit means process, dividing the process into number of unit, and 1, 2, 3, 4, each of which can be reside in different part of memory, so that in the memory location, each part, this is a process, will be divided. One part may sit at this location, and the second part may sit at this location, and third may be sit at this location, and fourth may be wherever the in the memory it is free, wherever in the memory it is free, it will sit. Okay, so how it is possible? Because we are dividing the process into part, number of parts. New hardware is required to do this activities. Various method to do the partition. One is segmentation, paging, and paged segmentation. Paging, logical address space of the process can be non-contiguous. Process is allocated physical memory wherever the latter is available. Divide the physical memory into fixed size block. So divide the physical memory into fixed size, that is we call as a frame. So this is we call as a frame. So physical memory, and divide the logical memory into block size called pages. So logical memory, where we call it as a, this is a page which is of fixed size. Keep track of all the free frames. So keep track, to keep track the way which are the memories or which are the frames are free, for that you required one more memory, that is hardware is required to track this which are the frames are free. To run the program of size n pages, need to find n new n free frames and load the program. So if the pages, if there is a three page 1, 2, 3, then you required n, that is three free frame in the memory. Set up the page table to transfer the logical to physical addresses. So from the page, the logical address will be produced. Along with the logical address, you should add offset so that you can allocate the address in the secondary memory. So address translation scheme. So you have a page number and offset. So page number is an index in the page table which contains the base register or base address of each page in the physical memory. So you can know that in this memory you have a base address as well as limit register as well as base registers. So with help of this base register, you get the base address, and which will be helpful to place a processes in the memory. Offset is combined with the base address to define the physical memory address that is sent to the memory unit. So there is, along with the base address, along with the offset addresses, so the one address will produce that is the address to the to load the process in the physical memory. So you can see here CPU will produce the logical addresses, and that will be placed in the page table. With the help of the page table, addresses along with the offset addresses will place the process in the memory location. For to do that, we required a hardware. So one example they have given, page 0, 1, 2, 3, this is a logical addresses, and page table they have a 1, 4, 3, 7. So page 0 page is being stored at the location 1, 0, 1 page is located at the location 4, 2 page is located at the location 3, and 3 page is located at the location 7. So all together, so this is a page table. So in this location, see, at location 1, page 0 is placed. At location 4, page 1 is located, stored. And at location page, there is 3, 2 is stored. And 7, 3 is stored. And you may ask, why page 1 is placed below the page 2? See, whenever the CPU allocates the logical memory and when it is stored to the page table, at that point of time, page, there is a frame 1 was free, but frame 2 and 3 was not free, and so page frame 4 came into existence. So page 1 is being stored to the page frame 4. So during storing the page 2 to the page table, at that point of time, page 3, that is frame 3, was free. So frame 3 came into existence, so that page 2 is allocated to the frame 3. Then page 3 is allocated, because 4 and 5 as well as 6 is already occupied, so 7 was free, so it was allocated to the 7. So this is how it will be allocated the frame from the logical memory to the physical memory. So one more example they have given, you can see here of 32 byte and of 4 byte pages. So 4 byte pages, so you can see here 32 byte memory, and this is of frame page frame 1, 2 and 3. So 0 is located at the location 5, and 1 is located at the frame 6, and 7 is 2 is located at the 1, and 3 is located at the 2. See here, and this is of addresses 0 to each one, each frame is of 4 bytes. So 1, 2, 3, so 0 to 4, 4 to 8, 8 to 12, 12 to 16, 20, 24, 28. And this is of frame 0 frame, first frame 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so the 0th page will be sit at the frame 5. So this is a frame 5. It stores A, B, C, D. So at the frame 5, it sits the A, B, C, D. And at frame 6, page 1 will be set at frame 6. What it is, E, F, G, H. So E, F, G, H is being seated at this location. And at frame 1, page 2 will be set, frame, that is I, J, K. So frame 1, I, J, K is being placed. And at frame 2, page 3 will be placed MNOP. So at 2, MNOP is being placed. So this is how the paging will work. So free frames, so free frame list 14, 13, 18, 20 and 15, these are the free frames are available in the to allocate the pages in the frame. So you can see here page, that is a frame 14 and frame 13 and 18 and 20 and 15 are freely available. This is a new process entering. And see here, in the frame list 15, my frame list 15, so 0 is being placed at location 14, and 1 is placed at the location 13, and 2 is placed at the location 18, and 3 is placed at the location 20. Okay, 3 is placed at the location 20. So page 4, that is page 0 is placed at the frame 14, and 1 is located at the frame 13, and 2 is located at the frame 18, and 3 is located at the page that is frame at 20. So free frame list is 15. 15 was occupied by some other processors, so before allocation, and it was free now, because it was allocated, it was freed after allocating all the pages to this frame, then it was make it free. So since there was only 4 pages, only this frame has been occupied, and frame 15 was free, so it is empty now, right now. So this is how the free frames were works, and this is what the picture represents. Implementation of a page table. Page table is kept in main memory. Page table is kept in a main memory. In the main memory, see, OS is placed, as well as page table is also kept. One part of the main memory is given for the page table. page table base register points to the page table. Base register is point to the page table, and page table length register indicates the size of the page table. So size of the page table may be of 2K or something like 512 MB, something like that. It being stored in the length of the register. In this scheme, every data instruction access requires two memory accesses, one for the page table and one for the data instruction. Two memory access problem can be solved by the use of the fast lookup hardware called cache. So cache, see here, CPU along with the cache along with the page table, this is cache, page table and memory. So instead of CPU, instead of accessing the page table from the main that is main memory, whichever the process is required, before that, see, whenever it accessed the process from the main memory, it has to look up the table, page table, as well as it has to look up the offset, then it has to load it to the main memory. If the cache is placed in between, some of the processes which is frequently accessed will be placed in the cache. It looks up the in the cache. If the cache is not in the cache is not there, then it goes to the main memory, then it do the operation. Some TLB, associate memory, store the address space identifier in each TLB, that is in the PCB address space identifier been loaded. Uniquely identify each process to provide an address space protection for that process. So associated memory or parallel search, so page number as well as frame will be for example page 1 frame 10, something like the page 2 frame 20, page 3 frame 11, etc. like that. And translation, if P is associated register, get the frame number out. Otherwise, get the frame number from the page table in memory. See here, that is what TLB. This is a cache. If the processors, if whatever the processors is searching by the CPU, if it is not available in the TLB, then the processor, that is a, if it is found, that is a TLB hit. If it is not found in the TLB, the process which is not found in the TLB, then it is a hit, TLB miss. Then from that, it has to go to the, to get the frame as well as offset address, and it has to store it in the physical memory. Effective access time. Associative lookup is equals to gamma time unit. Associative lookup table is, there is nothing but searching the page table is of represented by the epsilon time unit. Assume memory cycle time is 1 microsecond. Hit ratio, that is percentage of the time that page number is found in the associated register. Hit ratio is of alpha. Effective time, access time is 1 plus alpha, that is n, 1 plus epsilon plus 2 plus epsilon into 1 minus alpha. So if the hit ratio is found, if the process is found, it will be found at the, for example, the process will be placed in the location. If it is found, then in 1 hit, it going to find, that is big O of n, 1 plus epsilon. Epsilon is nothing but associative lookup table. To look up the table, it's required epsilon. If it is not found, then it is of one time is used for the memory access and one time used for the to lookup table. So 2 plus epsilon into, because since it is failure, 1 minus epsilon alpha. So this is what the hit ratio, that is effective access time. So 2 plus epsilon minus alpha is the effective access time for the process to identify in the memory. Memory protection is implemented by associating protection bit with each frame. Valid invalid bit is attached to each entry in the page table. So valid and invalid bit is been associated in the each page table. So valid indicates that the associated pages is in the process logically address space and is thus legally page. Invalid indicates that the page is not in the process logical address space. So you can see here page 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 frame numbers is been see 0 page is been placed at location page 0, page that is page 1 is placed at frame 3, etc. like that. And valid and invalid. So since there are only 5 pages, so 5 pages is valid, VVV is a valid, and 1 bit that is since 6 and 7 is there is invalid. I is represent invalid and V is represent valid bit. Shared pages, shared code as well as one copy of the read only code shared among the process. One copy of read only re-entered and code shared among the process, that is text editor compilers Windows system. So only one copy of the read only will be shared among the processes. Shared code must be appear in the same location in the logical address space of all the process. So there will be a one shared memory, that is a shared code, that is there will be number of process where this process will be sharing the code by all the process. That is a shared code. Private code and data. Each process keeps a separate copy of the code and data. So each process will have separate data will be there as well as code. The pages for the private code and the data can be appear anywhere in the logical address spaces. So shared page example, you can see here ED1, ED2, ED3 and data 1. This is a process 1, and for process 3 ED1, ED2, ED3 and data 3 for process 3, and ED1, ED2, ED3 and process data 2 for process 2. So 3, 4, 6 is used for this. 3, 4, 6 is used for the process P1, and data 1 is the is used to store in the frame number 1. And ED1, ED2, ED3 is also sharing the same thing, but to store the data 3 it is used some other location. And ED1, ED2, ED3, see here, this also sharing the same frame, but data 2 is stored on some other location. So data 1, data 3 and see here ED1, ED2, ED3 is sharing the same 3, 4 as 6, but data 1 is stored in the frame 1 for the process P1, and data 3 is being stored in the frame 2 for the process P3, and data 2 is stored in the frame 7 for the process P2. So this is how it will share the resources which is common to other process. Only the which is not common, that is being stored in the separate frame. So where we can reduce the memory location in the physical disk. Structure of the physical table. So structure of the physical table or structure of the page table, we have a hierarchical paging, hash tables, inverted page tables. Hierarchy page tables break up the logical address space into multiple page tables. We'll divide the logical address into multiple page tables, P1, P2, like that. A simple technique is two level page table. So two level page table, you can see here in the outer page table as well as page table. In the outer page table, see here from 0 to 500. So 1 is 0 to 500 will be mapped to the memory, and from 100 also will be mapped to till 708. This is our two level paging. So this is inner page and this is outer page. So that is what each inner page is also been have a outer page, and it will be mapped in the memory location. Two level paging example, a logical address is divided into page number consisting of 22. If 32 bit page is there, a logical address, and 22 bit is used for the page number, and 10 bit is used for the offset bit. And since page table is pager, the page number is further divided into 22. See, this is outer page, and inner page is out of 22, 12 is divided into page number, and plus 10 is divided into offset number. So this is, see, 32 bit how it is been divided, page number, that is this is inner page, Yeah, this is outer page and this is inner page number, and this is inner page offset and this is outer page offset. When PI is an index into the outer page table, P2 is a displacement within the page of the outer page table. So that's what is P is the index of the outer page and P2 is the displacement. So this is entirely is PI and this is P2. So PI and P2. So PI, that is P1, is a outer page and this is a displacement for the inner page. And we get the x value, that is a offset number, offset value for P2, and from the P2 we'll get the outer page displacement. We'll add it to the offset number to get the actual address of the physical address. 3-level paging is something outer page, inner page and displacement. This is of 64-bit address bit. Hashed page table common in address space, that is 32-bit. The virtual page number is hashed into page table. This page table contains a chain of element hashing to the same location. Virtual page numbers are compared in this chain searching for the match. So logical address space and physical address space hash function. So hash table is being placed. So hash table, there is a so for example x of 10 means 10 mod 11. What is the answer? We'll get 10. So the address will be stored at the location 1 to 10. Address will be loaded at the location 10. For example, x of 15 means so 15 mod 11. So what will be value? 4. So this address will be stored at the location 4. So this is how it will be stored in the hash table. So 4 along with offset address will be stored in the physical address space. So inverted page table, one entry for each real page of the memory. Entry consisting of the virtual address of the page stored in the real memory location with information about the process that owns the pages. So decreases the memory needed to store each page table, but increase the time needed to search the table when page reference occurs. So for PID will be generated by the CPU, and PID along with the page will be stored in the page table, and index will be stored in the to get the physical address along with the offset address to get the to store the content in the physical memory. Actually comes as air segmentation. Memory management schemes that supports the user view of memory. That is, memory is a collection of segments. Segment is a main memory, procedure, function, methods, objects, common blocks, stacks, symbol, table, arrays. So this is what the segment is, a logical unit. So each program is been divided into segments. Each program, one may be a subroutines, one may be a stack, one may be a symbol, one may be a main memory, one may be a square root. This is an example. So this is what actually a logical address is. So each program is being divided into subpart, that is segmented into subpart. So logical view of segment, that is one is being stored in the first frame and second will be stored at some other location, 3 some other location, 4 or some other location in the main memory. Logical view of the segmentation. So it's a piece of the program is being, each that is program is being divided into number of pieces, and wherever the memory location finds a free spaces, it keeps on storing the each segment. So, segment architecture, logical address consisting of two tuple. One is segment number and offset. What is segment table? That is, maps the two-dimensional physical addresses, each table entry as a base and limit registers. Segment table base register points to the segment table's location in the memory. Segment table length register indicates the number of segments used by the program. So for example, this program may have a 2 segment. So this is a 2 segment number is used by this program. That will be stored in the segment table length register. So segment number S is legal if S is lesser than the STLR. So point to the segment table location in the memory. So 2 should be lesser than the STLR. Protection: with each entry in the segment table associated validation bit 0, it is an illegal segment. Read, write, execute privileges. So if your validation bit is 0, then it is an illegal segment. Protection bits associated with the segments. Code sharing occurs at segment level. Since segment vary in length, memory allocation is a dynamic storage allocation problem. Segmentation example is shown in the following diagram. So each segmentation, it requires an additional hardware. So segmentation number, that is segmentation, will check the limit register as well as base register. If it is lesser than or equals to the segmentation, then proceed, otherwise trap the error. If it is lesser than the limit register, then add with the base register and get the location in the memory location. So example of segmentation: subroutine segment 0, stack 3, segment 3, symbol table segment 4, etc. So limit and base registers will be added. So 1000 is a limit and 1400 is the base register. So for this segment 0, 1400 is the base register. So 1000 is a limit. So 1400 to 1000 means 2400 is a limit. And next for this segmentation 1, it is starting address, it is a base register is 6300 and limit it is 400. So 6300 plus 400 is of 6700. So this is how you place the segmentation, there is a logical address space with the segmentation table in the physical table. This is how you're going to load it. So by this we have wind up, or we'll end up with the memory management, so which is covers module 3. So module 1, in the module 3, first chapter is a deadlock and second chapter is memory management. So thank you. If you have any doubt, you can ask in the online session class. Thank you all.